Good evening.
Welcome to St. Anne's as we celebrate the third Sunday of Advent. This evening we will be singing the Mass of Renewal, and it begins with the Holy on number 878. Our entrance hymn is number 39, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My friends, today on this third Sunday of Advent, we celebrate what is known as Gaudete Sunday. Gaudete, a Latin word meaning let us rejoice. This is the midpoint of our Advent season. We now have kind of like climbed that first part of the hill, and now as we finish out our Advent season the next couple weeks, we begin to kind of begin to see the end in sight, the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. The rose-colored vestments that I wear today are a very powerful symbol of that joy and that expectation, that hopeful expectation that we have for the birth of Jesus and the hope that we have in God himself. And so as we prepare ourselves now to enter into these sacred mysteries of Jesus Christ, we begin by calling to mind our sins as we ask God for his pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who see how your people faithfully await the feast of the Lord's Nativity, enable us, we pray, to attain the joys of so great a salvation and to celebrate them always with solemn worship and glad rejoicing. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The desert and the parched land will exult. The steppe will rejoice and bloom. They will bloom with abundant flowers and rejoice with joyful song. The glory of Lebanon will be given to them, the splendor of Carmel and Sharon. They will see the glory of the Lord, the splendor of our God. Strengthen the hands that are feeble. Make firm the knees that are weak. Say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication. With divine recompense, he comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag. Then the tongue of the mute will sing. Those whom the Lord has ransomed will return and enter Zion singing, crowned with everlasting joy. They will meet with joy and gladness. Sorrow and mourning will flee. The word of the Lord. The Lord God keeps faith forever, secures justice for the oppressed, gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets captives free. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord raises up those who were bowed down. The Lord loves the just. The Lord protects strangers. The fatherless and the widow he sustains, but the way of the wicked he thwarts. The Lord shall reign forever, your God, O Zion, through all generations. A reading from the letter of St. James. Be patient, brothers and sisters, until the coming of the Lord. See how the farmer waits for the precious fruit of the earth, being patient with it until it receives the early and the late rains. You too must be patient. Make your hearts firm, because the coming of the Lord is at hand. Do not complain, brothers and sisters, about one another, that you may not be judged. Behold, the judge is standing before the gates. Take as an example of hardship and patience, brothers and sisters, the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When John the Baptist heard in prison of the works of the Christ, he sent his disciples to Jesus with this question: "Are you the one who is to come, or should we look for another?" Jesus said to them in reply, "Go and tell John what you hear and see. The blind regain their sight, the lame walk, lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the poor have the good news proclaimed to them. And blessed is the one who takes no offense at me." As they were going off, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. "What did you go out to the desert to see? A reed swayed by the wind? Then what did you go out to see? Someone dressed in fine clothing? Those who wear fine clothing are in royal palaces. Then why did you go out? To see a prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom it is written, 'Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way before you.' Amen, I say to you, among those born of women, there has been none greater than John the Baptist. Yet the least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he." The Gospel of the Lord.
So I may have told you at one point in time, back in college, I knew a guy, his name was Norman. And he was about 2 years ahead of me in college. He was a really nice guy. Everyone knew him on campus as the one who would do anything for anyone. He was actually kind of a local kid to the college town. And he didn't really care who you were, what you did, where you came from. He was kind of the kid that was always friends with everyone. And the thing that impressed me the most about Norman, however, was the fact that no matter where he went, no matter what he was going through, he always seemed to manage to have a smile on his face. There was always a reason for him to be joyful. And I knew his mother. His mother actually sang in the choir at the church that I was in as well. And she was the same way. You know, she was always laughing, always joking, always had this joyful spirit about her. And it's beautiful to see that pass along then to Norman. I remember one time I was having a conversation with Norman, and he began to open up about one of the struggles that he was having, about how he had to slip away and no longer take part in one of the organizations that he was involved in because they were doing some questionable things that he didn't want to be a part in of. And the thing was, you know, I had this conversation with him, and I expected this to be something that would really bring him down. Because he had really made some really good friends in this organization. They had done some really good stuff around town and on campus. And to know that he had to step away from that, I would certainly be excruciatingly troubled by that. But the thing about him was that he found extreme peace in this. In that decision to walk away. He found joy in the midst of the struggle, despite the weight of that decision on his heart. He was able to make that decision and just move on with joy and enter into whatever moment God has from him from that moment on. And when I talked to him about it, I remember him describing his reasons for stepping away with quite some gravity, but always expressing this great confidence and this great peace that he had made the right decision. And once again, in true Norman fashion, big smile. And ever since I had met him, he later became a priest down in Kentucky. And ever since I had met him, I always looked to him as a model of joy. And ever since I had met him, I said, I want to have that same type of joy that he has. You know, I wondered often to myself, you know, how does a person have such great joy all the time? Because I certainly don't have that. And the majority of people I meet don't have that all the time like Norman did. But how does a person have such great joy all the time? That's the question for today. And today is a perfect day to really contemplate and reflect upon that question, because today, as I said, is Gaudete Sunday. We're reminded of that joy that we're to have in Christ Jesus. Let us rejoice. Gaudete. Today is about living in the joy of our Lord. Anticipation of his birth. And that should bring us great peace and great joy. And even though we don't celebrate his birth yet, we have that joy because we know that it's coming. And there's something about that that brings us peace, to know that it's going to happen. You know, I think back to the Old Testament scriptures, and for generations, the people of God were made a promise by God that he was going to send them a Savior. And while the wait was long, while the wait at times was excruciating, and the people had to go through so many hard things, the promise was fulfilled. It did happen. We know, living 2,000 years ahead of that time, that Jesus was born 2,000 years ago in a little manger. Our Lord lives among us. You know, so these 4 weeks of Advent right now are meant to help us to identify with the longing of God's people before Christ's birth, a longing that they held inside their hearts for so long, and to see how they kept that hope and that joy alive, even in the midst of the hardest of struggles, not because God had already fulfilled that promise, but because they believed that he would. They believed that God was with them, guiding their steps to prepare their hearts to receive the joy of the fulfillment of his promise. And frankly, that sustained God's people for generations, hundreds of years. You might even say thousands of years if we go all the way back to Moses and Abraham. And you can imagine, you know, just how complete that joy is when Jesus was actually born. You know, how do we hold on to that type of joy, that joy of anticipation? You know, when I was a kid, I used to make multiple trips with my brothers and my mom or my dad or others to the amusement park just outside of Cincinnati. And I remember every time, it didn't matter how many times I went to this amusement park, every time the night before, I would get so worked up that I could not sleep, because I was just thinking about all the fun I was going to have riding the roller coasters and the bumper cars and everything else up and down and around. I no longer like to go around and around. So, I lost that ability a long time ago. But when the day finally came, you know, my kid-like joy was complete. You know, that happy little kid just running around the amusement park, sometimes getting lost, but filling up on the sweets, the elephant ears and such. And it's that anticipation of what was to come brings just as much joy as actually receiving it and experiencing it in the moment. And that's how joy should work. It's not just in the attainment of what we desire, but even in the anticipation that it's coming, that the day is coming, and it works us up, our heart, with this joy-filled hope. Now, we have a promise that God is indeed working in our lives. He's working in our hearts in the midst of sorrow and disappointment and failure and loss. He's working to repair broken relationships. He's working to strengthen weary hearts. He's working to bring people back to faith. He's working to bring joy where there's despair, and forgiveness where there's anger, unity where there's division. You see, God is a God who has made this promise. And he has appointed a day when all of this is going to be fulfilled in our midst. But even though we're not like there yet, we should have this kid-like joy that God is going to fulfill that promise. And we should have that joy as if we've already received it. And as Scripture has said so many times before in the past, that's a reason why we should not be anxious about anything. Because we know the Lord is working in our lives. But, you know, I know the reality is, you know, for myself and for many of us, you know, it's very easy to get stuck in the negative, to only see the challenges and the hardships, to not see any way out of a difficult situation, maybe to get caught up in what we don't have or the way things could or should be. We get caught up in all the bad stuff that's happening. But in those times, what does the Scripture speak to us? What promise is spoken? What word do we receive? St. Paul today says, in those times, be patient and make your hearts firm. Because he knows that when we do that, when we have that firm faith in our God and in his promise, there is the root of joy. Whenever we worry, whenever we're anxious, whenever we obsess over how things are going to turn out, we're forgetting the truth that God is actively still working in our lives. But if we acknowledge that God is working, that we truly believe it, then that opens up the possibility to really lessen that anxiety, to almost have no anxiety at all. Because then we would willingly lay all of our needs at his feet. We would surrender everything to him, confident that he has heard our prayer and he will answer. So what do we do in the meantime? What do we do as we're waiting for God to act, even as we trudge forward in the midst of our problems? Yeah, we could focus on our problems. We could worry. We could get anxious. But just as St. Paul said, so also John the Baptist seems to allude to today as well. He says to focus on the promise of God. Focus on what he said God would do. What will take place? He says, "Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, and he will prepare the way before you." God is sending his word to us, a message of hope, a promise. And I don't know about you, but I can't wait to keep hearing a message of hope that I can hold on to. It's an invitation to keep our eyes open to the signs that God is doing something in our lives, that he is actively working to fulfill our greatest needs, and maybe in little ways that we don't always recognize, maybe in big ways, that we do. But all of these signs, he is working, and that gives us courage and it gives us hope. And there's joy in holding on to that. Great joy, because it's a gift. We don't have to wallow in sorrows, but we can prepare our hearts to receive him in beautiful, wonderful ways as we wait for that joy to be complete. And we know through faith that day is coming. God is faithful. God is good. The light is about to shine, and we are sure of that God will answer our prayers, just as we are sure that in less than 2 weeks, our Savior will come into the world as a tiny child. That's the point of today, to rejoice in that promise. God is faithful. And so we hold on to hope. We remain faithful. We give thanks. And we rejoice always. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now, my friends, in great faith and confidence, we come before our Father, laying before him all of our needs and petitions.
For Pope Francis, our bishops, all priests and deacons, for all who hold and teach the Catholic faith, May they be faithful in opening up to us the mystery of Jesus Christ through word and sacrament. We pray to the Lord. For a deeper experience of the love, hope, and joy of this Gaudete Sunday, which comes from the joyful expectation of the coming birth of our Savior, Jesus, we pray to the Lord. For the sick, elderly, disabled, and homebound, may they find strength and comfort in the presence of Christ and the loving presence of others. We pray to the Lord. For our families, may our homes be places where the love of Christ abounds as a witness to the world. We pray to the Lord. For our parish community of St. Anne's, may we be united in our mission and vision to spread the gospel message faithfully to those most in need. We pray to the Lord. For the souls of all the faithful departed, especially Leon Glazier and Craig Glazier, may they know the mercy of God and rise with him to new and eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Almighty Eternal Father, on this Gaudete Sunday, we turn to you as we lay all of our needs before you, that our joy may be complete. We ask this all through Christ our Lord. Amen. At this time, any little ones present among us who have an offering to make, you are invited to step forward and place it in the basket at the foot of the altar.
Please join in singing our offertory hymn, number 48, Beyond the Moon and Stars.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, be offered to you unceasingly to complete what was begun in sacred mystery and powerfully accomplished for us, your saving work, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Anne and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, his assistant Joseph, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Now, at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us now offer each other the sign of peace. Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. We implore your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feasts. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. A big thank you to our adult choir for leading us in music today. And we don't get the honor that often to have them sing at the 5:15 Mass. So this is such a special treat, especially on this Gaudete Sunday. And even better, it's online now. So everyone gets to hear it. So we get to kind of spread your talent and your gift to everyone. So thank you for being here. They'll be singing again. They've been preparing for Christmas, our Christmas celebrations, which are coming up in 2 short weeks. They'll be singing at the 9 p.m. Christmas Eve and 9 a.m. Christmas Day. Just so you know, the Christmas schedule for our Masses is adapted a little bit this year. So Christmas Eve next Saturday, 2 Saturdays from now, 4 p.m. and 9 p.m., and then Sunday morning, 9 a.m. So that'll be a little bit different on our weekend traditions and routines, but we'll keep reminding you in the next week or so. Thank you again also to Bev for playing today and guiding us, and for Megan for directing our choir as well. So we're very appreciative of all that you do. Please feel free to stop by our script table today after Mass. We have gift cards available for purchase. Restaurants and retailers, remember, a percentage of all sales comes back to support our ministries here at St. Anne's Parish or School. Also, at the script table tonight, this is your last opportunity to pick up discounted tickets for tomorrow's Dad's Belgian Waffle Breakfast. So you can pick up a discounted ticket or tickets today at the script table. So that waffle breakfast is tomorrow from 8:30 to 12 noon at St. Anne's School. All you can eat waffles, sausage, and toppings. Come and support and come and just share fellowship with one another. Also in conjunction with that is a cookie walk sponsored by our patrons. You can buy and purchase cookies by the pound. Do all of your holiday baking, or at least tell everyone you did the baking, or tell them the truth. That's probably better. St. Anne's CCW is accepting donations to go towards Christmas flowers for our altar. If you would like to donate in memory of a loved one, please make your check payable to St. Anne's CCW and place it in the collection basket, or mail it, drop it off at the parish office. And then finally today, we'd like to offer our condolences to two families who lost loved ones this past week. To the family of William Byron, who passed away on December 8th. His visitation will take place this Tuesday afternoon from 4 to 8 p.m. and again on Wednesday morning at 9:30, all at Colden's Funeral Home. And his funeral will take place on Wednesday morning at 10:30 at the Church of St. Thomas. And also we offer our condolences to the family and loved ones of Rita Schmal. Rita passed away on December 7th. Her visitation will take place next Saturday, December 17th, here at St. Anne's, beginning at 1:30 in the afternoon. With the funeral mass beginning at 2:30 that afternoon. As always then, we offer our condolences to the families. We pray our prayer to the Blessed Virgin for the repose of their souls as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. May they rest in peace. And may their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Please join in singing our closing song, Number 573, Let Heaven Rejoice.